And so what God has he's done, he's transferred us to this new life. And I want us to think of it, maybe this would be a better way to describe it, understand it. There's a guy that I like to read, his name is Martin Lloyd-Jones, Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones. He passed away a few years back, and he gives a great illustration. He says, you know, there's two kinds of people, okay? So imagine yourself, there's two fields, right? There's two fields. There's one on this side and one on this side. And in these, on these fields, there's huge brick walls, stone walls that surround each one that you cannot, there is zero chance for you to ever climb out and escape. And one of these fields is the condition of all of our lives apart from Jesus. It's a field ruled by Satan and sin. It's a place where we are slaves and we are stuck there. You are there, you are in that position. But God in his mercy reaches down, pulls us out, plucks us out, and places us in a place, in a field where Christ and righteousness rules and reigns. That we are given a new life, we're given a new master, we're given a new identity, we're given a new purpose, we're given a new freedom, we're given all of these new rights, and we're in this new life over here where the bondage has been broken, we have been set free, right? We're there. This is what that means. Our status has been changed. But sometimes, or many times for us, you can still hear Satan and sin's voice calling to you over the wall, trying to control you, trying to get you to follow what they say, trying to have you obey them, trying to have them think that you're still under their rule. Anybody relate with that? How do you stop that? Well, get away from the wall, right? The farther you go away, what happens? The fainter the voice becomes. Get away from the wall. Start going deeper into Christ. And you start seeing that I have this new identity, that my status has really changed, that I have been purchased, that I have a new life now. I don't have to be stuck anymore because God has given me everything I need right now. You lack nothing to do all that God's called you to do, to live in freedom. You lack absolutely nothing. He's given it to us all already right now for in Jesus.